Hi, my name is Timothy Jordan, and I'm a developer advocate on the Glass team here at Google. And today I'm joined by Jeff Eddings of the Turner Emerging Technology Group. Jeff, welcome.
Hello, thanks.
How you doing?
I'm great. Thanks for having me.
So you are the man behind the CNN Glassware.
That's right.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about the glassware and what users seem to think of it?
Sure. When we first heard about Glass, we thought right away that we needed to have CNN news alerts on there. It was a natural fit. And so when we first started working together, we were super excited about doing it, and our users seemed to love it as well.
So. Mm-hmm. Now, what I love about the glassware is that I find during the day, during my business day, I'm really, really busy. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the night, you know, I'm like often like hanging out with family or friends, and if I'm reading fiction, I don't usually sit down and like read the newspaper. Mm-hmm. But I like getting alerts throughout the day. I like staying current on world events, and I find with CNN, it's really easy to do that. Like, mm-hmm. I can get the cover card and quickly glance at it, or I can view the video while I'm walking between meetings, and I still sort of know what's going on in the world,
right.
But I didn't have to take a large chunk out of my day.
That's right. And news is some of the most perishable content that exists out there today.
Mm, yeah.
The older it is, the less relevant, the less important it is. And so for us to be able to get news out to users when it's happening, right after it happens, that's incredibly valuable. And so for us, like I said, you know, this was a really exciting project for us. We're very keen on understanding how these kinds of glanceable technologies work and how people consume news differently with those.
That's awesome. And the videos work really well on Glass.
They do.
Right?
We were a little bit reluctant, or not reluctant, hesitant about going into this because, you know, we were afraid that the video wouldn't quite look right. We were very pleasantly surprised. They actually look awesome, and we've been really pleased by it. And our users have told us the same thing. You know, they've told us the videos look really, really good, and that's what they really like about the glassware.
Awesome. Okay, so today we're going to talk about two new things that came out with XE8 for the platform on the Mirror API. The first was the video player.
Mm.
That we've updated it, mm-hmm. so it has controls for play, pause, rewind, fast forward, and HTML pagination. Let's start with the video player.
Sure.
Kind of got that one for free, right?
We did. It's the best kind of features when we don't have to do anything at all to improve it. So it's been great. One of the things that our users were saying, you know, can I pause the video? Can I rewind or fast forward? And we, you know, we sort of shrugged, but now it's like, you know, like we get to say very, very confidently, yes, that is in there. It works great, and we're thrilled that you guys put it in there.
Awesome. Now the next one, HTML pagination. I'm going to talk through it mm-hmm. with some slides in a moment. But I think the key thing here is that you were getting rich content with multiple screens of information on Glass mm-hmm. using bundling before,
right.
Which wasn't necessarily the best way to use bundling, and also tripled your cost for like insertions per user.
Mm-hmm.
But now with HTML pagination, it's a little bit different.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, this is a great feature for us. You know, from our perspective, we were able to rip large amounts of code out and simplify what we were doing as well.
Mm-hmm.
As you said, the cost went down, and it just made things much more easier to maintain. It's a very smart way to present that data and send it to you guys without having to manage multiple cards and what if one failed but another one didn't.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's been actually a really tremendous feature for us. We also have content in there that we were troubled. We didn't know how to display it to the end user. Do we put it on multiple cards? Do we reduce the font size? Now with the new pagination feature, we're able to just put it in there, and you know, as long as we have the right tags in there, set it and forget it. So.
Very cool. So let's take a look at some slides here. I just want to show everybody out there a flow. This is a single CNN timeline card. You'll notice there's a cover card up in the upper left there. And if you tap into it, you get your menu of options as usual. But here you'll see play, read more, and read aloud. Play will go straight to the video. If you swipe forward to read more, that's the HTML minus the cover card. And that will auto-paginate depending on the size of the text in that article. And then read aloud will, of course, read the speakable text to the user. Now in code, and this is always the coolest part because these features are so easy to implement on the Mirror API, here's the JSON, and it's as you would expect. You got HTML, speakable text, and the menu items. All you need to specify for the menu items is read aloud, because play you get since there's a video attached, and then the read more you get because there's multiple pages in the HTML. The HTML looks like this. It's done with block level tags. So you'll notice there's two article tags there. The first one is cover only, so that's only going to show up on the cover. And then the second one, you'll notice its class is auto paginate. So you can have many article tags, and that would be a deliberate, you know, separate page. But if you set the auto paginate on an article tag, then the text within there will grow to the number of pages it needs to contain it. And that's it. Video player, HTML pagination, and then hopefully we're gonna keep working on this and see some more stuff.
Absolutely, we're really excited about some of the things that we're working on right now to extend the CNN Glassware. Right now, we're sending news out to the individual subscribers, and they get to read that throughout the day. But we think there's a real opportunity for actually gathering news using using the Glass device, and so those are some exciting days ahead of for us, and hopefully, you know, by the end of the year, we'll have something great to show.
Awesome. Well, we're really looking forward to that.
Yeah, thanks.
Thanks for coming by, Jeff.
Thank you.
Everyone, we'll see you later.